The work entitled the relaxation parameter of cupron substrate type coated systems under non-indentation was performed at the Laboratory of Mechanical Properties of Materials, the Institute of Applied Physics. This work was aimed to the investigation of the mechanical properties of coated systems depending on the type of the substrate, and therefore it was chosen the following substrate: lithium fluoride, magnesium oxide, and silicon, which was investigated earlier and with known mechanical properties, and therefore we would like to compare their behavior depending on this different substrate, which have different mechanical properties. Lithium fluoride is considered a soft ionic, it is considered soft material from mechanical point of view, and further magnesium oxide and silicon are hard monocrystals which have a ionic covalent or covalent type of bond. All this substrate was covered with the cuprum film of different thickness. For each of this substrate, we have three thicknesses of the film. 85, 470, and 1000 nanometer. And the coating was fabricated by magnetron sputtering for each type of substrate. The experimental details, this work we use for mechanical investigation, the depth sensing nano-indentation on the nanotester device with Berkovich indenter with which represent the diamond trihedral pyramidal tip, the optical microscopy, atomic force microscopy, and chemical etching by etch pit technique. The non-indentation process include the main stages of loading and unloading. During loading, the deformation of material takes place, and during unloading, the relaxation of accumulated stresses with the relaxation of indentation depths takes place. And from this parameter of the depths of indentation, we can characterize the elastic-plastic relaxation of the material. And namely, in this work, we have studied the elastic-plastic relaxation of the indentation and the residual depths of indentation. It is presented the non-indentation curves for lithium substrate, for cuprum bulk, which it was used as a target for magnetron sputtering, and the non-indentation curves for coated systems, and namely for three thicknesses of the film, and for different loads applied. And as one can see, the deformation behavior is very similar. So the shape of the non-indentation curves are very similar for lithium fluoride and cuprum substrate, such that the relaxation of the indentation imprint is very weak. So the material deforms mostly plastically. And for the coated systems, we have the similar behavior, a little bit with more relaxation, which I will discuss later. Further, for these are the non-indentation curves for coated systems with the magnesium oxide and the silicon substrate. And we can hear that these substrates, being harder, exhibit a more pronounced elastic plastic relaxation of the material. And here we can see for the coated systems the rather pronounced influence of the substrate, even at rather low loads. Less pronounced and more pronounced with the increase of load. And even for silicon, which is known to exhibit a pop-out effect due to the phase transformation of silicon during unloading, we can see for high load that this effect also appear. So the influence of substrate increases with the increase of penetration depths controlled by load applied. The relaxation parameter was summarized and plotted on graphs, dependencies. On the load applied, and one can see that here it is presented the elastic plastic relaxation and the residual depths. And one can see that for soft on soft coated system, cuprum on lithium fluoride, relaxation parameter for the substrate and for the coated systems are rather closed. Only at higher loads they differ, but in this we explain by the cracking of the substrate and the delamination of the coating, which I will demonstrate later. For the soft and hard coated systems, their behavior changes, and we can see that the parameter for the substrate are close to the parameter of the coated systems and the parameter of the film is situated apart from these curves, and the effect is more pronounced with the increase of hardness of the substrate for cuprum on silica. And the effect is even more clearly seen on the residual depths, depending on the load applied, and where we can see the curve for the film cuprum, which and for the coated systems and substrate, which are close situated, and the curve for film is situated far from this one, and higher difference can see for with the increase of hardness of substrate and the difference in the hardness between the film and the substrate. The evolution of the relief around the imprint as a function of load on cuprum, on lithium fluoride coated system is presented here, and you can see the evolution for the same, we use here the same thickness of the film, 470 nanometer, and you can see here the evolution from the lowest load, 20 nanometer, till the highest load, 900 nanometer, and you can see here. Here it is presented in reflection mode regime of optical microscopy, and here in interference mode. And it is clearly seen the formation of the fracture around the indentation and the cracks around the indentation and the delamination of the film, which I told earlier contribute to the higher elastic plastic relaxation. Increase of this parameter of elastic plastic relaxation. Next, here I would like to present the images obtained on atomic force microscopy, and here we can compare the evolution of the relief around the indentations by changing the thickness film for the same load, and we can see here very pronounced pile ups around the indentation, which is in fact caused by the delamination of the film from the substrate because of very thin film. And the hard substrate, which during the indentation influenced by the development of very large elastic stresses around the indentation, and during recovery of indentation, this delamination takes place. And with the increase of the film thickness, this effect diminishes because the substrate is not has a less contribution to the whole deformation. And here you can see also atomic force microscopy images on the cuprum on silicon coated systems. Also, we can see the delamination for thin substrate and the decrease of this effect with the increase of the film thickness. And the decrease of load. Here we have 50 nanometer and 20 nanometer load applied to the indenture. Further, the dislocation structure, the relaxation parameter that I presented earlier refer to the elastic plastic relaxation, but for the investigation of the plastic behavior of substrate, after the indentation, we removed the film by chemical treatment, and further, we performed the etching of the substrate and revealed the dislocation rosettes, so the dislocation structure around the indentation, which is created in the substrate beneath the film. And with the increase of load, one can see that the influence of the substrate concerning the plastic contribution to the whole deformation increases, and it is very clear seen that the dislocation resets extend with the increase of load. And here we can see even the imprint underneath the film, which remains on the substrate, and the well-developed cracks on the substrate of magnesium oxide. So both the film thickness, the type of substrate, the indentation depth, which is controlled by the load applied, influence on the mechanical behavior of coated systems. And by analyzing all these results, we could make the conclusion that for penetration depths smaller than 0.5 film thickness, the deformation extends mostly in the film. With the increase of load and respectively the increase of indentation depths, the deformation is extended in the substrate. And with the increase, further increase of load and the indentation depths for indentation depths higher than one thickness film, the deformation takes place mostly in the substrate, with involving the mechanical behavior of the substrate. I would like to mention here that the four hard material with rather well-developed elastic deformation during loading, substrate can contribute to the deformation even for indentation depths which are rather small comparatively with the thickness of the film, because of very high elastic strain and stress, which extend far deep in the substrate and influence on the deformation behavior, which we could see on the non-indentation curves and on the relief of indentation around the imprint. And in the conclusion, the elastic plastic relaxation during indentation for soft on soft cuprum on lithium fluoride and soft on hard cuprum magnesium oxide and cuprum on silicon coated systems showed the following peculiarities. One, the influence of the substrate on the elastic plastic relaxation is greater for soft on hard coated systems than for soft on soft ones, which is demonstrated by closer values of elastic plastic relaxation parameter for soft on hard coated system and substrate than for soft on soft coated system and substrate. Two, the parameter of residual depth of the imprint shows even more evident the influence of the substrate on the relaxation process, the values of which for the coating are far higher than those for coated systems and substrate. The effect is as more pronounced as the difference in hardness between the coating and substrate is larger. At the same time, the process is influenced by the relation between two factors, the penetration depths, which depend on the applied load and the film's thickness. And the larger the relation between the penetration depth and the film's thickness, the greater the contribution of the substrate. Thank you very much for your attention.